And I hate that I let you stop me. Cause it hurts when you hurt somebody. One day before you know it, you will see all of the pain and all the irony, yeah. You'll feel the sting and then you'll think of me. Cause it hurts when you hurt. Hold me close and I won't leave. Cause it hurts when you hurt.
Good morning, Phoenix High School, and you are watching PHTV with the white team this morning. I'm Bryn Jones.
And I'm Karina Carrera, and we are down to only the final four episodes of PHTV for the school year. Let's get started.
To start off with today, we have announcements for seniors. Seniors, if you have turned in your baby pictures, please come pick them up in Mr. Rhodes's room in 206A. Along with that, the last day to make changes to your presenter for graduation will be May 18th.
Senior, si usted entregó fotos de bebé, por favor vaya a recogerlas en la habitación N206A del señor Rhodes. Junto con eso, el último día para hacer cambios a su presentador para la graduación será el 18 de mayo.
Moving on to news from our art department. On Tuesday, May 8th, Phoenix High School had three of the Oregon's top selections for 2018 Congressional Art Competition. Nora Keel won top honor and will have her work on display in Washington, D.C. for 1 year. Vivian Turner and Lupita Aldrea were runner-ups for Oregon and will have their art displayed in Representative Greg Walden's office. Great job to all three of these amazing students.
On the topic of art, the art show starts next week on Monday, May 21st, and will run through Wednesday, May 30th. Our very own Nick Doran made a segment to promote everyone coming out and checking out this amazing work. Let's check it out.
All year, the art students have been working hard on drawing, coloring, painting, and much more. An event that is closely approaching, called the Art Show, will allow the art students to show off all their hard work. Next week, May 21st through the 25th, art will be displayed in the Commons for everyone to see, with some of the pieces even available for purchase. The art will be separated between the different classes, and at the end of the Art Show, Wednesday, May 30th, certain pieces will be awarded as best at this event. Please do not touch or steal any of the artwork on display.
Some exciting summer news for students now from the Future Planning Center. Local college and career advisors have reached out to Phoenix High School for student volunteer help with LEGO Engineering summer camps hosted at the Ashland YMCA. It is an excellent first job for students that might be looking to make a little extra money over the summer or maybe saving up for college. See the Future Planning Center for more information.
Algunas interesantes noticias de verano. La universidad y el consejero de carreras nos han contactado para que ustedes ayuden con los campamentos de verano del LEGO Engineer en el Ashland YMCA. Es un excelente primer trabajo para los estudiantes que podrían estar buscando ganar un poco de dinero extra durante el verano o pueden ahorrar para la universidad.
If you are interested in earning free money for college, traveling across the country, learning about trade, or getting your GED. AmeriCorps offers all these benefits through 6 to the 11th month long programs that give you unique experiences. If you want to learn more, come to the AmeriCorps workshop on Thursday, May 17th during the 4th, in the library. Please sign up for the Future Planning Center.
Otra buena manera de ganar algo de dinero, si está interesado en ganar dinero gratis para la universidad, viajar para todo el país, aprender sobre el comercio o obtener su GED, AmeriCorps ofrece todos estos beneficios a través del programa de 6 a 11 meses, que le abrirán experiencias únicas. Si desea obtener más información, visite el taller de AmeriCorps el jueves 17 de mayo durante el cuarto periodo en la biblioteca. Inscríbase en el Future Planning Center.
The Muscular Dystrophy Association is looking for student volunteers interested in helping their annual MDA summer camp. This is a great senior project opportunity for next year.
To volunteer at the MDA camp, a person needs to be 16 years or older, pass a background check, and complete a pre-camp physical. Camp is July 14th to the 20th in Salem, Oregon. Lodging and meals are provided for the duration, and we offer 140 hours of service hours for the week. We will also work with students if they have a school project or something above or beyond just needing service hours. If you are interested in this opportunity, please see our athletic director, Mr. Earhart.
This next announcement is for any student who has taken eCare and has an expired first aid CPR card, or one that will soon expire. Ms. Campbell is holding a renewal class after school this Thursday, May 17th, in her classroom. If you have after-school commitments, please make arrangements with your coach or instructors ahead of time, as you will miss part of your practice. If you plan on attending this renewal course, please see Ms. Campbell to sign up.
In FFA news, a very talented group of students came home last week from the FFA state competition with a state championship. PHS would like to congratulate Maddie Dodd, Elise Morris, Casey Kuckendall, and Austin Voss, our food science state champs. Way to go, Pirates. Pirate FFA. Speaking of Pirate FFA, exactly 1 week from today will be the FFA award banquet. PHS own William Nathy and Daria De Los Santos made a segment to give you details. Let's roll it.
Dice is on the beat.
Annual FFA Awards Banquet. Award banquet will be on Monday, May 21st. The awards will take place in the Commons at 6 p.m. Hope to see you there.
Some additional news from FFA members about the 21st banquet rehearsal will be on Monday, May 21st, after school in the Commons. All FFA members are required to attend. Also mandatory national convention meeting Monday, May 21st at 5:30 p.m. in the Commons. If you want to travel to Nashville, Louisville, and Indianapolis with us next October, you must attend this meeting. Okay, it is sports news now. Our softball girls last week took on Klamath Union in a three-game series, coming out victorious in a three-game sweeping off the Pelicans on the season. Great season, Pirate softball.
In baseball news, our boys took on Klamath Union last week in a three-game series, coming out on top in all three games for the sweep. Great job, Pirate Baseball. Be on the lookout for a state playing game this Thursday at Culver Field. The Pirates will take on Douglas starting at 5 p.m.
Our track and field team has their district meet last Friday, and multiple members of the team qualified for the state meet this week. Sienna Bauer is in hurdles and triple jump, Anna Nash in the long jump, Lupita Alegria in the 800 meter, Corey Roaming in the 100 meter, Joseph Navas in the 400 meters, Robbie Voss in the 1500 meters, and the 3K. Joseph Grace is in javelin. Congrats to all the Pirate track and field athletes on a great season. Just for the team, Abigail Humphrey made a segment to celebrate another great year for our track team. Let's check it out.
Phoenix Track and Field.
What was your favorite part of the season?
My favorite part of the season was seeing myself improve along with the other throwers of the team and just everyone in general, just seeing us have a good season.
What will you miss after this season of track?
I really miss getting to hang out with all the friends I've made, the good, mainly the throwers. We've gotten pretty close over the season.
What do you want to work on for next season?
I just need to work on my form and keeping a level head when I don't always do my best.
Great season, Phoenix track and field.
In baseball news, our boys took on... Wait, hold up. Finally, in sports news, the girls' golf team got third place at the regional golf tournament at Running Y last week and is advancing to state meet this Monday and Tuesday in Banks, Oregon. Marcella Alvarado Powers got fourth place and Bella Lopez got sixth out of 56 girls. The team has had a good year of golf and will be graduating four seniors this year. Good luck, Lady Pirates at state.
That about sums up our show for today. Only thing left is trivia. Last week's question was, when is Ms. Campbell's CPR card renewal training?
And the winner is... Cassidy Hood. You said Thursday, May 17th. And you're from Ingridson's class. Congratulations. See Mr. Rhodes after advisory to get your Dutch Bros gift card.
This week's trivia question is, when does the art show start? Make sure to write your answer on a piece of paper along with your name and your advisor's name and place it in the envelope on Mr. Rhodes' door. Maybe next week you will win the Dutch Bros gift card. La pregunta de trivia de esta semana es, ¿cuándo empieza el show de arte? Asegúrese de escribir tu respuesta en un trozo de papel junto con tu nombre y el nombre de tu consejero. Y colócalo en el sobre de la puerta del señor Rhodes. Quizás la próxima semana ganes la tarjeta de regalo de Dutch Bros.
Be sure to stick around for the Pledge of Allegiance following our show. And as always, check out our online platform, phtvnews.com. Have a great week, Phoenix High School. This has been your school,
your people,
and your news.
Taking it slowly, I'm afraid to be lonely. Nobody told me it's harder than I thought to tell the truth. It's gonna leave you in pieces, all alone with your demons. And I know that we need this, but I've been too afraid to follow through. Hold me close and I won't leave, 'cause it hurts when you hurt somebody.